Building a great school list is one of the most important yet underrated aspects of your medical school application process. Getting this right or wrong can genuinely mean the difference between you getting into med school and having to reapply. Therefore, I was thrilled to receive the following submission for our Ask Dr. S series. How should you go about making a school list if you have a high MCAT score and high science GPA, but very low cumulative GPA from before you were a pre-med? I failed a number of classes along with multiple C's and D's when I was a philosophy major with poor time management. Since deciding to be pre-med, my GPA is 4.0 and I expect this to continue through graduation. If I look at the average cumulative GPA of medical schools, I'm pretty much below every school. If I consider only science GPA, then I am competitive. My projected MCAT score is also quite competitive. So my question is, how do I think about making a school list considering a very low cumulative GPA, high science GPA, and high MCAT? All right. Even though I don't have the specific cumulative GPA and science GPA since this student started college, or even their MCAT score, this is a great question. It's hard enough as it is to build the right school list. Most students simply look at the median GPA and MCAT score for a given school and apply to schools whose average stats are at or below theirs. They might then sprinkle in a few undershoot schools, schools whose median stats are a good bit below theirs, and a few reach schools because they wonder, hey, why not? Can't hurt, right? First things first, purchase MSAR, which is a comprehensive database of MD programs. I've linked to it in the description. By signing up for MSAR, you'll have access to up-to-date and official stats from each med school. The really nice thing about stats on MSAR is that schools report 10th, 25th, 50th, 75th, and 90th percentile scores for every important statistical category. MCAT total score, MCAT section scores, total GPA, and science GPA. In addition, you can filter this information based on whether you're interested in seeing data for all accepted students, in-state and out-of-state, as well as all matriculated students. Why is this level of granularity important? Because it allows us to not only see whether you're at or above a school's median stats, but also where you stand relative to other accepted students. That way you can know how much below your low cumulative GPA is and how much above your high MCAT score is from a school's expectations. For instance, you might be slightly below the 50th percentile overall GPA, but above the 75th percentile MCAT score, which would be an okay place to be stats-wise at that school. Now, I get a lot of questions from students about whether their stats are too low for a given school. They might be concerned about a single 124 MCAT section score or a 3.4 science GPA. A useful rule is to see whether or not your score of concern falls below the 10th percentile among all accepted students at a given school. If so, then it might be especially difficult to get into that school. For example, a program's 10th percentile CAR score might be 125. In that case, having a 124 might be a major problem for you. Beyond that, the way to approach your school list, stats-wise, is to see where you stand relative to an institution's expectations and consider how competitive or conservative you want to be. Specifically, I advise you to set a clear decision-making bar for your school list. If you want to be especially conservative, you might decide, okay, because my cumulative GPA is a 3.5 and my MCAT score is a 522, I'm going to consider schools where my 3.5 GPA is at or above their 25th percentile and my MCAT is at or above their 90th percentile. That way, you can effectively balance your lower cumulative GPA with your higher MCAT score. Now, if you want to be less conservative, you can simply move the needle and consider, say, schools where your overall GPA is at or above their 10th percentile and your MCAT score is at or above their 75th percentile. To be clear, there is no 100% right or wrong way to do this. It's simply a matter of deciding how competitive or conservative you want to be and understand the associated risks and upside. If you go super conservative, you increase your overall odds of getting into a med school, but risk not getting into the best possible schools you could have gotten into. On the other hand, if you apply to a more competitive list, you reduced your overall chances of getting into med school, but increase your chances of getting into the best possible schools based on your profile. You could also simply expand your list so that you can more effectively balance out the number of super competitive programs you apply to with programs where your stats exceed their averages. There's an art and science to developing a great school list. We haven't even gotten into questions like, how many schools should I apply to? Or how many MD versus DO schools should I apply to? Or how will I be viewed by XYZ schools as an applicant from California? Those questions can be covered in a future video. But for now, I hope this helps clarify how to navigate disparate stats when putting together your list of schools. All right, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out on future videos in our Ask Dr. S series. And if you have a pressing question of your own, make sure to submit it in the form I've linked to in the description. All right, I'd love to hear from you now in the comments section. What struggles do you have with developing your school list? I'll read all the responses and respond to most. Take care.